Hey guys, happy Friday, folks. I wanted to go through a very quick blog today. I saw a friend of mine do a blog similar the other day, and it got me excited to share the same information. And it kind of goes into the discussion of fascia that we've been talking about loosely for the last month as the new organ, the interstitium, was described or announced by science. But what I want to do is I want to use this little model here to explain a little bit of how we look at fascia and from a holistic standpoint. And what this is it's actually it's called a tensegrity unit, and it's a bunch of wooden dowels and a bunch of rubber bands. And it was created, the word was created by an architect by the name of Buckminster Fuller. And it is basically an architectural term, and it is kind of, we use it in a word in the anatomy world is, if these are the bones, these wooden dowels, and these rubber bands are the fascia, or the muscle, let me say, and the muscle is surrounded by fascia, and the bones are surrounded by fascia. Hey, Alexis, what's up? I like to describe how when we look at the body holistically, if we were to affect one muscle here, let's say this one muscle between my fingertips is, let's just say it's the quadricep, and the quadricep is super tight and bound down. Watch what happens to all of the wooden structures when I twist that butt muscle. Every bone in the body, or every bone in this unit that I'm holding, is actually moving as a result of one piece of tissue being tight in the body. So now let's just say this foam roller is a nerve, and it's running through the body between bones and fascia. And then down here, way away from that nerve, we get a tightness of the hip flexor. And all of a sudden, it bounds down and it moves the whole structure. The pool noodle moves, the wooden dowels move, the rubber bands move. So when someone says, how does fascia in my psoas affect what's going on in my neck and shoulder? Well, this is the way we can demonstrate that. Because a lot of times I'll have a client that'll come in with neck pain, and I'll do something in their psoas or their diaphragm to help with their posture, and they don't think it has anything to do with their neck, and then they sit up and their neck pain's vastly improved. So this is a scenario where I use this little tensegrity unit to describe that to my clients and how fascia works and whatnot. So that's all I got for you today. Hope that makes sense. Y'all have a fantastic weekend.